Hi mom, so welcome to day two of the Winter Nature Challenge. I hope that yesterday you had fun looking through the list of winter nature activities and maybe it encouraged you to get outside and do some new things with your kids. What we're gonna do today is we're gonna talk about goal setting and why we want to complete certain goals. So let's start with our why. And this is a relatively simple question. And why did you join the Winter Nature Challenge? Was it just to get outside more with your kids? Was it to connect with other families who have similar interests as you? Was it to learn kind of my key formula for dressing kids in winter to keep them warm? Whatever that was, write it down in the section that says your why in the worksheet that you downloaded. Then once you have identified your why, and just FYI, the why can be anything. It can be something that's highly practical, or it can be something that's more philosophical. It's really whatever is on your heart. Go ahead and write that down. And then after you get that, then we're going to work on our goal. So our goal relates to our why, right? Why do we want to get outside more? Well, our goal might be more nature time this month. And so those two are going to correlate, and that'll help you to kind of stay motivated and keep everything in perspective as you go through this next month trying to meet your goal. So what I want to talk about now are SMARTer goals. And I'm sure you guys have all heard of the acronym SMART goals. So those are specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound. And this is simply a template or formula for writing a goal so that it actually happens. And then I've added here the SMARTer formula, which was developed by Michael Hyatt. He is really big in the goal setting and in planning to actually accomplish those goals. And he added these two pieces, which were that the goal's exciting, because if you're not excited about it, you're probably not going to do it. And then number two, it needs to be risky. So if you set a goal for something that you could easily do on any normal day, then it's not really a goal. You're not moving forward and achieving something, right? It needs to be a little bit out of your comfort zone. So using that framework, write a goal that is based on the reason that you are in this challenge. And it may take a few minutes to come up with, and might need to just kind of sit with it for a little bit. Some of you guys, you probably know exactly what you want to say and exactly what your goal is. The key is this goal is for this month. And we want to keep it at this month because at the end of the month, we want to come back and check to see if we've actually met our goal. So let me give you an example of one of my goals. So one of my goals for the entire year is 365 in 2019. And so essentially, I want my kids to be out for at least an hour every single day for the year of 2019. So that's my goal for the year, but I want to write something that's more specific, not only so that it's more measurable for this month, but also to basically accommodate the month of January, right? Because it's much easier, at least for me, to get outside in the summer months than it is for the winter. So let me read you my goal for this month. To get outside with the kids every day for at least a little bit and have 5 hours of total outdoor time over the week. And so this is, number one, it's specific, it's measurable. I can see at the end of the month if I met these metrics. It's attainable, it's relevant, it's time bound because it has a daily metric and then a weekly metric, and that's something I can look at the end of the month and measure it. It's exciting because, it's exciting because we're getting outside every day, right? But it's risky because, you guys, I live in the Southwest for a reason. I really enjoy being warm. And right now it is 15 degrees outside. We have had back-to-back blizzards and there's like 2 feet of snow on the ground. And getting outside in that weather, especially when it's not sunny and it's still blowing a little bit, blowing snow, doesn't exactly, you know, get me excited to go outside. So it's risky in that sense, but it's exciting because it's something that I know I can do and that I want to do with my kids. And so that is my goal for this month, that I can measure at the end of the month and see if I met it. And then, like I said, I shared my yearly goal with you, which I also think is very exciting. And it'll help keep me on track. So we're gonna talk about how we put these goals into our schedules tomorrow to make sure they actually happen. Because as many of you guys know, so many people write goals and New Year's resolutions and they never get past the first or the second week. That's not what we wanna do. We want to make sure that our goals are written in such a way that we can plan them out, and then we can actually measure if we met them at the end of the month. So I hope this helps. Make sure you fill out this worksheet, and then post either your why or your goal online. If you need some help making sure that your goal is a smarter goal, then post it in the Facebook group and we will help you out.